Hey folks, Ben from Snowy's today with the Blacksmith Camping Supplies clear top draw bag in the large size. Hit it. This is a large square draw bag with a divider in the middle. It's got enough capacity to fit a kitchen kit for a family of four or just about all the tools you'll need for any outback expedition. And this is the second iteration of draw bags that Blacksmith has made. I thought their first ones were great, but they keep wanting to improve theirs and they've upgraded them to these bags here, which have now got a PVC lining and different colours on the outside. We'll go into all that shortly. The bag itself weighs a bit under 900 grams, about 880 grams, and measures 46 centimetres by 46 centimetres at about 16 centimetres in height. It's made wherever they can with Australian material. So the canvas on the outside, before I go into it, I'll mention there's two colours. There's a black canvas, which has a grey interior, and a khaki canvas, which has a black interior. So whatever suits your camp setup. This is a 370 GSM Australian-made canvas, Dynaproofed Australian-made canvas, really good quality canvas. Inside is an Australian 680 GSM ripstop PVC tarpaulin. I'll show you that shortly, makes it nice and easy to clean. The clear PVC on the top here isn't Australian made. It's actually a Japanese made product that they use here at the moment for quality reasons. It's 0.5 mil outdoor blind grade PVC. It's UV stabilized, so it's gonna stay clear. It's not gonna yellow or crack over time. Quality components used to put it together as well. YKK zips that run all the way around here. Single zips, got two zip pulls on there so you can unzip it and zip it up from either side. It's all put together with a good quality or high quality coarse spun poly cotton thread. So all of this is a really good quality thread that's used to put it all together, and 38 millimeter webbing that runs along this side here for a little grab handle, just on the one side for the grab handle there, but then there's these handles that come up over the top to make it easy to carry. And there's a nice length of handle there, so it's not so long that it hangs really low when you carry it, but just long enough that the handles come together neatly over the top when it's full. Should also mention these handles actually go right around the bottom here, so this webbing isn't just stitched in on the side here, the weight is distributed right around the base here, so you're not just relying on this stitching here to carry the weight. Now inside the bag, I'm going to open the top here now. As I mentioned, two zippers that go right around to the back edge here, well, around the back corners here, so this top folds right open there and out the way, so you can leave it open when you're using it. And you can see inside here you've got this divider, this full width divider here. This is just attached by hook and loop tape on the side here, so there's the hook tape on each end of this divider here, so you can take this out completely if you don't want to use it, but that's PVC line sort of padding in the middle. There's some marine carpet or something inside there just to give it a bit of padding, and that marries up to these loop strips here that run all the way along each side here, this side here and the opposite side here as well, so you can put this in here at any point you like. So if you've got thin things you want to put down one side, larger things on the other, you can put that wherever you like. And as I mentioned, the upgrade or the version 2 of these bags has this PVC lining inside, makes it really easy to clean. So if you have got food spills or anything in there, or maybe you're keeping tools in there and there's a bit of oil and that sort of thing, really easy to keep this clean inside if you need to. It's probably most prevalent if you're using it as a kitchen kit. Now I've got a random assortment of items, very random assortment of items to show you what you might be able to pack inside here. So I've grabbed a heavy duty cast iron skillet there so I can put a bit of weight in there and pick it up and show you how easily it carries. I'm just gonna pack all this randomly. 3 liter billy there. This is probably about a 2 to 3 liter kettle there as well. Fit that inside, just spin that around. That fits there. A couple of mugs that I can put in there as well. Let's just tuck them in down here maybe. I think I've got some utensils here too, so nice long set of tongs there, a little bit long for that there. It's got a little bit that sort of sticks out there. I'll push that in, fit these down the side there. Probably lay the mugs in there with it. I'll put the mugs down here actually. That's very randomly sort of worked out. So very loosely sort of put a bit of a kitchen kit in there. I suppose you might have some plates and bowls, but you can certainly fit more plates and bowls in there as well. Pick that up and you can see it sags a little bit on the bottom, but nice and easy to carry. The handles are a really good length and that will slide in and out easily in a drawer in the back of the car. Use this handle here to slide it in and out. Alternatively, you might be able to use it for say some tools or a recovery kit perhaps. So I've got a snatch strap down here that I'll throw in. So let's just convert this from a kitchen kit to a tool kit. So hammer, a few guy ropes, some inox spray. Take all this out. And yes, I do have a snatch strap down here. Stick that in there, fits nice and easily. A few large pegs as well, if I like, are gonna fit down the side there. Still got tons of space in there. I could fit probably a recovery dampener in there too, if I like, some D-shackles, probably an entire tool kit in there would fit in there nice and easily. And you can keep it separated with that divider in there. So probably a little bit heavier than the fry pan in there at the moment, in there now at the moment. That's a snatch strap, weighs a little bit, but obviously tons and tons of space. And if you need to squash this down a bit, you can just sort of squash the top and it's gonna fit in underneath a shelf in the back of the car. But for me, my shelf's about this high, so that would fit nice and neatly under the shelf in the back of my car. A million and one uses for bags like this from a four-wheel drive camping caravan perspective. So storage for whatever you like. And if you grab a few of them to make up your kit in the back of your car, you can stay really organized no matter how you camp or where you camp. Check these out online at snowies.com.au where you find them at our lowest prices every day. If you've got any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest information. Check out some other videos like these ones down here.